to Speedbowl, the 1991 Z28 Camaro, courtesy of Cody Chevrolet on the Barre, Montpelier Road. Ambulance service by Barre Regional Ambulance. Our record crew for 30 years and counting, Dick Blake and the gang from Lake and Luxor, Route 14 at East Montpelier. And the Luxor Wood Marinato, Route 2 also at East Montpelier, even if red. The American Canadian Tour infield truck, the Cody Chevrolet push truck, and last week's defending champion, we'll introduce them in just a moment.
Robert.
Steve Miller, Chuck Meany, and Jim Silly. We're down to seven.
Yeah.
Michael Knapp. 69, Rupert Irwin qualifies in second. And ladies and gentlemen, here's your winner in turn number four one more time, and you're in Tony McKay Jr. Bill of many years will start third, and on the outside, car number 85 from Barre, Mike Duncan. The top rookie on the soccer tour, Big Bigger Louie, car number 4, goes next to line, outside, the defending Thunder Road track champion, Brother Lane, in car number 27. From Montpelier, Vermont, or from rather Hardwick, Vermont, Cap Perry, in car number 62. Perry, in 62. Get out of that car. spot for the 94 of Mark Lanphier. In second, the 27, Greg Berger Blake. And ladies and gentlemen, returning the colors in turn number four, equally what a perfect job for Morrisville. Wild Bill Herring. car number 6, Louisville 50 line, outside last week's feature winner, Claude Cross in the 49. Scott Allen from Hardwick in the 27, outside for Waterbury, Jimmy Young in car number 1. Henry B. Callison, last year's rookie of the year in car number 7. Outside Billy Barkham in the 71, a brand new Neil Greenwood from Bill Barkham, who said, I got to take it out and dip this thing up so it feels comfortable. John Murray green, car number 80, the 31 of Ralph Carroll. What shall we have him? In the 50 green, number 85 is Cal Lewis. Wonderful Randy Sayers in the 07, the 64 Bryant, Brian Williams. Scott Hood in the 97, the top rookie on the Tiger Tour. The 99, on for a while, but everything's all right now. Jim Devaney's problem last year in this is that he was just too darn nice. Somebody put him in the wall and he'd go over after the race and apologize for getting in the way. About 3 weeks ago, he said, the heck with this, I'm going to be a jerk like everybody else, and since then, he's been doing pretty well. Barre Hewlisberg, he's got a couple of feature wins already this year, and he's got himself a checkered in E4. One more time, ladies and gentlemen, Hewlisberg returning to color. Semi-feature coming out for the Pepsi Flying Tigers. Top three qualifiers from each of our qualifying heat races. Ready to go for bonus cash and bonus points. Defecto, car number 75, will be your inside pole sitter. Well, we got some heavy hitters going around for this one. This is like a mini feature tonight. Defecto on the pole, outside the rookie, Kit Stockwell in the 16. Row number 2, the 5 of Pat Corbin, 12, Bobby McCaskill. Turner Blake in the 27, and Stroman, Norman Andrews side by side in row number 3. Row 4, Doug Whitmer, Rupert Irwin, and the double 0, Steve Miller. Mike Knapp in car number 80, the 94, Mark Lambert. corner. Yellow clouds to hit 00513. Yeah, let's go on to the family ticket. Purple family, 00-1788. Either one of those tickets, drop up to the back row of the tower, tucked up. Hi, Brandy Lynn. Hi, Brandy Lynn. She doesn't understand. She hears me from down there and sees me up here. I'm confused. My second favorite two-year-old. We're still looking for Yellow Child's ticket, 00513, Purple Family ticket, 00-1788. You got to stop up here to the tower. Semi-feature time, now I'm going to run short. This ought to be a wild one. Joe Steffen in the 00-65, Harley Benjamin will hold down the front row. Reggie Mountain in the 77, and I keep Jerry Himmister. Jeff Darney, car number 14, and Randall Randy in the 07. There's a third row for you. Car number one, Jimmy Young, and Disney King, Gallus number 7. Billy Nye, Guy Brown, Todd Curry, car number 3. Dorian Tiger, car number 4, and the entrance. Race car is in. 12 rock listeners, top qualifiers. Three trucks, wheels wild. We got a feature yet to come. How about in turn four, start it off with a long man as he comes back to the semi checker. Michael Randy Slayer, speed for two tonight in the 07. Feature time for the Pepsi Flying Tigers, and this is the toughest race of the night. The top three finishers will get the option to advance and start on the tail end of the main event. The rest will load it up. We will see you next week for the Time Targets Mid-Season Championship. P3 Brian Campbell will be your pole sitter outside the 15 Ford Thunderbird for Joey McNair Sr. Dan Gibb starts the 97 in the third spot, outside the 77 of Michael Mudd. Alex Hart Jr. in the 84, and the 57 Jim Martin side-by-side in row 3. Dale Packard in front of the 62, the 13 of Richard Lindsay. usual, the lead feature for the tires tonight. Richard Bussey gets the third spot at the tail end of the race. David Gibbs comes out second, go to the care, wins it. We'll get them out of the cars and find out if they're going to go on. Bussey says, I'm an old man, I can't get out this way. All right, number three finisher in the meet feature. Rich, come on down here. Richard Bussey in the 13. First of all, congratulations. Now the $100,000 question, you got to move on and start at the rear of the A main. Practice. He needs to practice. He's been here 20 years and he's going to the A to practice. Richard Bunsey, the 13. David Gibbs, 97. David, nice run to second place. You got to go?
Yes,
we're going to go. All right, there's two to me. David Gibbs goes in the 97. And this is probably going to be the dumbest question of the night. Go in the care of the 15. Cars look up good, you're going on. down on the inside, and he's going to end up about 28. Right front. Thank you. back for the Morrisville driver, Timmy Young, in car number one. Timmy, nice ride. Have your shot on the outside there, thought you might give the old radical run for his money.
They did what we had. We were a little bit too hang on out there. Pony kind of like slipped back down in and really appreciated it. Had a lot of bad luck. The guys were sticking with me, sponsoring.
Well, for the first time in a month, you got a trunk on this car when it's all over. That's a step up.
Yeah,
Timmy Young, second place tonight. Gets an over to you on that one. And how about this guy? Three wins and three aces. Yeah. Yeah. Randy, say hello to KC Gray. We've got a trophy for you. What's the difference tonight? Finally just came together for it.
Yeah, we came together. I couldn't believe myself. Was
three for three tonight. Now they're going to put you out back next week. You know that, don't you? All right, Radical Randy, the 07, gets three tonight. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to take a very brief 15-minute intermission. Oh, Bob, is that right? All right, we promised you it would happen. We're going to do it right now. Since the Radical won the Triple Crown tonight, right down here at the start-finish line, Bobby has the official Radical Randy Racing T-shirts, and they're going to mark them down to, what, seven? $7. Ordinarily, 10. Tonight, they're 7. Get them while they're hot. Hey, Bob, you won the Triple Crown. Make it 5. All right, $5 for the Radical T-shirt. Hell, I'll take one for 5.
Still on the point, driving car number 75 from Morrisville. The rearview garage for a Regal Perfecto. Outside pole and running strongly tonight, one of the top rookies on the Tiger Tour from Randall. In the Randolph Auto Supply, Stockwell's Garage, Buick Pip Stockwell, car number 16. Row 2 on the inside, the TC Catering, Chevrolet Malibu, car number 5 from Williamstown, Pat Corbett. And alongside Corbett, driving car number 07 from Colchester, the L&M Chevrolet Nova, Fernandez Carrick, car number 07. Row 3 on the inside and running as well as we've seen him run in a long, long time. The GW Tatra, Ford Thunderbird, from Hyde Park, Vermont, Boss Hog, Roadmade. And outside me, ready to go 6 tonight, the Clark Investments, Dodge Aries, car number 12 from Williamstown, Bobby McCaskill. Post position number 7 tonight goes to the Midas Mumford Brake Center, Buick Regal, car number 69 from Waterbury, Rupert the Flipper Earlier. Outside Irwin, also hailing from the city of Waterbury, car number 29, the Simmons Cable Chevrolet for Brad Wheeler. Row number 5 on the inside, the Fullis Insurance Pontiac Grand Am, car number 4 for the top rookie in the Flying Tiger Division, Big Bigelow. And outside Bigelow, first feature win ever a few weeks ago here at Thunder Road, the Mead Chevrolet, car number 23 for Mike Potter. Row 6 on the inside, the Ernie's Garage, Tri-Town Sunoco, car number 27, defending Thunder Road track champion, Bernard Blake from Barre. And outside Blake, one of the great veterans of racing here in the nation's side of excitement, the Kingsbury Oldsmobile Sierra, car number 2 for Stoddard, Noah Andrews. Inside row number 7, the hottest driver on the Tiger Tour in 1990, the County Tire Pontiac, car number 00, and Steve Miller. Outside Miller, solidly among the top 10 drivers here at Thunder Road in 1990, driving car number 55, the Kentucky Colonel, Tom Tiller from Essex Township. Next row back on the inside comes the Goss Dodge, car number 54, the former Thunder Road and Vermont State Flying Tiger Champion, Chuck Meady from Barre. Feature winner a couple of weeks ago here at the nation's side of excitement, the G&M Team Racing Pontiac 6000 from Montpelier, Michael Knapp. Next row back on the inside line, the Chassis Dynamics, Buick Skylark, car 94 from Boston, Mark Lanphier. And it's a family affair on the outside of that row, also from Morrisville, Vermont, the defending Vermont State Flying Tiger Champion in the Artist Department Store Oldsmobile Playland Mirroring Photography. The time target, Chevrolet, comes next in line on the inside. Number 68, from Gordon, Vermont, here's Jim Silly. And outside Silly, he is on a roll again tonight. He won a seat, he won the semi, and goes for the triple crown. Number one in Thunder Road points, Silly McNair Jr. in number 61. Inside Maxwell, long-time competitor here at Thunder Road. Richmond Office Equipment doing Carbon 97 and Dave Gibbs from Jericho. And outside of Gibbs, by virtue of a top finish in the B feature, car number 13, the J&A Enterprises doing for Richard Mutsey, car number 13. Starting in the 23rd position tonight, by virtue of the Plan 1 option, for Waterbury, Vermont, the Nakayo Concept, Chevrolet, Camaro, Scott Carpenter in car number 36. And Ryan Shotgun, post position number 24 tonight, also by the Plan 1 option from last year's High Point standing. The J&A Enterprises Buick. From Colchester, Vermont, Jimmy Martin, Nick Donner, 57. Ladies and gentlemen, that is the starting field. We ask now that you please rise for the playing of our national anthem.
Thank you.
Thank you. still got their helmet on, they want to go racing again. A couple of tires and you may do it. Thank you. tell you what, you won a lot of races this year, but you won't get a tougher run than this one tonight.
That was a good race tonight. Dennis drove a really super race. Young Zone, right there. Joey was fast.
You happy with second then?
Third.
I'm sorry, he would have been happy with second. He's happy with... Steve, forget it. Steve Miller, double zero, the third. And...
Long
letter board,
no Steve Miller. Here's
the hard chart from Bob Mama gets Steve Miller behind the double zero. Well, I guess the hard one kid tonight walked it on the final back shift and gave it a great run. Dennis Perrin in the 07. Dennis, congratulations. PC Craig from Bob Mama. Dennis, I don't know if you're feeling good or feeling bad right now. It's tough to lose one that way, but you really had it hooked.
Well, the guys are all looking for a win.
Second to this guy is nothing unusual. He's been doing it to everybody this year.
My brother Gary put the car together and all the sponsors. And a special thanks to Fairfax Owens and Alan Simmons for help.
All right, congratulations. Dennis Perrin, the 07, second tonight. And I'll tell you what, this kid is some kind of unreal tonight. Jim McCrone for Joey Deegan. I'll tell you what, it looked like you were going to have your hands full just to finish third tonight. Where did you find it on the final lap?
Well, I figured I got that far. I couldn't let off there. See, that or not finish. We've been. I'd like to thank my sponsors, Alan Lumber, Napa Auto Parts, Jim Shaw, Lowell McLeod, my mother, Marisha Motors, Carol Escovini, and all the other guys on the car here. All you guys behind me.
You ever had a race car like this in your whole life?
No, I love this one. My parents went with a job. I've gone. It works great.
Three wins in 1990. We're not yet halfway. Care tonight in the 61. Welcome back, still at the bottom, Creature Feature coming up next.
From Voyage, we'll have some repairs to make.
Rami Benjamin, number 65, to 71, Wild, Bill Largo. 75 is Trevor Neal, Kevin Kingsbury in the 29, Thomas Swire in car number 18, Doug Murphy in the 80. Brent Neal Mountain in the big boat, number 77. The 52 is Norwood Southward. Spuds McKenzie in car number 68, the 31, Ralph Carroll. Michael Perry Fleming in the 5. Jerry Emerson. Bill Harry in the 6 machine, the 25 is Steve Topping. Brandon Moody in the 58, the 36 is Ricky Roberts. Number 0, Mark Bonnier. 34, Randy Clay, and the new guy, 35, Ron Weston. Brian Coburn's car number 50 is immobile on the back straightaway. They fired up the field and pulled away. Either his motor's in trouble or Brian dozed off during the delay. Thank you.
front that only the front clutch can have. Early or third place car. We still have a real small Mickey Mouse sneaker up here for safety. Although if you stay out, you can probably win this thing. Bill Markham, Don Lowell, Joe Simpson, and Trevor Keeling.
Please drive carefully on your way home, and we'll see you back here next Thursday night. Good night, everybody.